Terry the anglerfish was a bit of a loner. You see, he'd lost his clout due to the fact his light had all but gone out. He tried bathing in reflected light on the chance of maybe grabbing a bite, but as far as Terry was concerned, he never found that truly fulfilling, due mostly to the fact the old dredger Terry hung around with wasn't much for spilling. Not even a solitary plankton got past his beady eye. At times, Terry was fair moved to cry, alone in the dark and pondering his fate. A seemingly insignificant fish swam up to his gate. Terry seized his chance and grabbed the blighter. He was only small, not much of a fighter. Fearing for his very existence, he told Terry, in instant and distant, he remembered a lobster happened to mention. He needed a cable, or was it an extension? For porch lighting, I believe. Terry feared the blighter was trying to deceive. He smelt a rat, or in this case a sprat. But half starved, Terry had all but lost his reason. The blighter reminded him it was the season to be jolly. Here, take my brolly. I believe it's starting to rain. Now I know you're taking the mickey, Terry said with disdain. You know, I'm already wet. Are you sure about that? Said the fry. Should we call the vet? I'm only wet behind the gills, as you ruddy well know. I think you should be on your way now. I think you should go. Look, look, this doesn't need much explanation. I was just trying to make light of a sticky situation. I'm nervous, said the fry, and you know very well why. All right, no need to cry. Be gone, go away. I'll waste no more time on you today. The fry said, but I wish to stay. You're barely a toothful anyway, said Terry. I wish to help, said the fry. I was always taught spread a little happiness as you go by. I won't rest till you're on your way and feeling your best. You do that for me, Terry mumbled. You know, I feel quite humbled. The fry stiffened his resolve and put his mind to Terry's problem and how it could be solved. The fry swam back and forth, face etched in concentration. Now, I know some will say the little fish had ideas above his station, but credit where it's due. He was trying to help poor Terry, and generally, helpful fish are really quite few. After several minutes of swimming about, Terry's mind wandered, and he considered transitioning and maybe becoming a trout. He'd be much more likely to get a square meal up top, instead of languishing down here, one great big flop. Then suddenly it came to the fry. In a blinding flash, he cut quite a figure, thought Terry, amongst all the trash. He told Terry how he could increase his meals. Check out the new shop in town, Electric Neals. The sign on the door read, if fish weren't biting, perhaps it's time to change your lighting. As the two entered the store, their jaws very nearly hit the floor. There was a vast array of coloured lights and fittings on display. I wouldn't mind betting yes. Upgraded to two must have fair singed their retinas. There was a kaleidoscope of colour that bombarded their senses. There were all types of bulbs from Edison screw, painted cap, large and small, and a lovely rug retro thing that would go well in the hall, mood lighting for your rockery to bulbs to show up your crockery. There were downlights, candle lights, traditional and glow, and something that flickered, which I believe was a strobe. There were angle poised lamps, Tiffany too, and all kinds of op-shaped dial that would go well in the mood. There was also coach lamps for porches. Right in the corner was a selection of what looked like torches. Terry was bewildered. There was just too much choice. So the fry stepped up to the plate to be his voice. Terry said the fry has a pressing need. He needs nutrition and fast, for without an inviting illumination hanging over his gob, I don't think it would last. Look at him, the great slob. As luck would have it, Neil had just a thing. It would help Terry, had just that touch of bling. Terry took Neil's advice and went for a crystal chandelier in a Rococo style. Well, you've got to push the boat out once in a while. There was just one thing still troubling Terry though. He wasn't much of a goer. These days he was just that little bit slower. Neil said, don't worry about energy usage, old son. You don't have to be much of a swimmer. The boffins have already thought about that. The lights on a dimmer. The fry was pleased to see Terry so chuffed, considering at one point he was looking royally stuffed. Well, the two bid Neil farewell and were soon on their way, and I understand the two remain friends to this day. But wait. I'm sorry, I can't continue in all honesty with this lie, and I think you must know, I think you know why. Terry was a fish after all. And when those pangs of hunger were upon him, I believe he answered that call. And what with the fry being drawn to Terry's new light, I believe the angler, in all probability, took his first bite. Just to try his new fitting, you understand. Things as if we need telling don't always go the way we plan. You may find this somewhat surprising, but I think it's how the fry would have wanted to go. Torn fin from fin and munch really quite slow. I know, I wish I could tell it was all over very quick. The mere thought of it makes me feel quite sick. But knowing what we do about Terry, he would have been wanting to save his strength. So he would have savoured every morsel and chewed slowly and at some length. That said, I feel the fry would have been okay giving up his life to save another. Because despite the obvious physical differences, it was still his brother. Terry regretted it immediately, of course. He was filled with remorse. He must have lay on that silt, wracked with guilt, for a good 2 minutes or more before he summoned up the will to get up off that floor. Please don't upset yourself now the fry is gone. Just think what a positive little fella he was and how brightly he shone. And for what it's worth, I don't think that was the end of the fry, though bodily it was. I choose to believe, and this is because, we all have an essence, a soul if you like, from the humblest krill to the commercially pike. I happen to know the fry's positive little energy will be whizzing about, looking for trouble and giving it one almighty clout. From the deepest trench to the darkest cave, he'll be looking for some poor critter to save. Maybe just giving them an uplifting thought in their hour of need, or lighting their way to their very next feed. As for Terry and his dastardly deed, he suffered indigestion every time he would feed. Some say it was remorse on account of the noble fry being his first course. All very traumatic for him, I suppose.